Frankly speaking, this is one of the most proper Stephen King novels I've read in a long, long time. Who am I kidding? I know what I look like. Welcome back to Nervous Reviews, where you get your daily dose of reviews. I mean, I know it's been a while, but you know, I'm back at it again for the classic Stephen King novel. Once again, you know how it is. We release these reviews day one of when the new Stephen King novel comes out. So, of course, I'm straight on the mark with that one. If you do want to hear more news, Nervous Review news, I guess, you're going to have to wait to the end. There's a timestamp in the description, so you can skip there if you want. Of course, you can skip it also. Billy Summers has absolutely bedazzled me. This is by far one of the most interesting Stephen King novels I've read in a long, long time, just because of the state of where Stephen King is right now. So it does appear on camera. You can see that these are the most recent Stephen King novels I've been reviewing since Outsider came out. And in that span, 6 books have actually come out. The most recent being this one, which I'll get to soon. Right before this was Later, which was pretty good. And before that was If It Bleeds, which is a bunch of novellas. And they were very iffy. I'm not sure what order these two came out in, but neither of these were any good. This was really awful. And this was just really lame. The Outsider was actually very, very good. And although I'm not sure how it holds up nowadays. So generally speaking, I think that you can tell what the state of King has been like recently. A lot of misses, but a couple of really, really golden shots like Later and Outsider, which makes it all the more surprising when this comes out. Now, I've got to say, I was considering not doing this review at all. I just finished reading this book, like literally an hour ago, and I was sat there thinking, how can I review something like this? How can I review something that's so close to my heart so suddenly? How can I review something that I know that my emotional judgment will cloud my logical judgment? I can't give a proper review for something that has affected me so much. And I know this might sound crazy to some people, but not all books affect me in the same way. Most books just tend to be okay to me, and there are a couple books that really, really make me upset that the world has ended. It makes me upset that this world that I've been reading through has suddenly come to an end. And I think that this book is one of the rare few books that I've ever felt that in. Billy Summers by Stephen King. And wouldn't you know it, guess who the guest for today is? That's right. Billy Summers himself. Give him a round of applause, guys. Come on.
私をここに連れてきてくれてありがとう。あなたの存在は名誉です。
Because of what I've been talking about so far, I think it's best to start with my Goodreads review of this book, which was, I find it difficult to believe that something so amazing, something so great of a Stephen King book, has so many garbage segments. Because I think that's just about true. Billy Summers is unequivocally one of the best Stephen King books that I've ever read. It is by far topping almost everything he's written in the new King era. Probably the thing that I've wrestled with most in this book is, what is Billy Summers about? And I'm not sure if this is the question. If the question, what is Billy Summers about? The answer to that is, what is Billy Summers about? Because maybe it is, maybe I'm just not getting things. But to me, it felt like that was the one question that went unanswered. As far as I can tell, the answer to the question, what is Billy Summers about, is a smart hitman who pretends to be a dumb hitman goes on his final job. And that's what it seemed like to me. So as soon as this book starts up, that's the expectation that's created. And it sounds very intriguing. I was very excited to see that. It started off slow, of course, but as it built on, it was a very beautifully interconnected web of past, future, of the people around him, of his influences, of what he plans to do in the future, of who he thinks he is within the status of the entire world. And that plot that you expect to be the main story finishes not even half of the way through the book. And you are left wondering, what could this book possibly be about? It felt like the end of the story to me. But clearly, the way Stephen King writes, you could tell it wasn't. There was more to it. But the problem was that this was not at all set up. It felt like this part of the story was meant to be a different book. This was not the same story that we started off with. And yet, in another way, it was. In another way, Billy Summers is not a story about an event. It's a story about a man. And as long as this man continues within the story is still his. Because following that story, we are led into this little thing that we can't imagine to be more than a small side plot. And it ends up being the entirety of the story. And this second story, at no point are you expecting it to take over. At no point does it even cross your mind that this could take over. And yet, it completely takes over. It is the entire story. And it leaves you wondering, well, what was the first half of this book then? What was it about? What was the point of it? What exactly is Billy Summers about? What do you think? What do you think, Billy?
その宇宙の状態について、その神について、そして生きることの重要性。人生は川のようなものです。その長く、驚くべき、そして時にはちょうど終わ
り。Alright, thank you, Dalton. That's an in-joke. If you get it, you get it. As the side plot moves on, in what is essentially the background of the main plot, we end up moving forward and the side plot, you know, takes up a lot of the time, which is fair enough. It was a very interesting side plot. And then it evolves into what we have in the main story ends up being sort of reflection of the side plot and we extrapolate from there. And all of this is to say, this story feels so segmented. It feels so put together. It feels like it is a bunch of different stories, a bunch of different short stories stuffed together to make it feel like one big novel. And I'm not complaining that it is a novel form because I think that that is how this works out. But I am complaining that it doesn't feel like a novel. It doesn't feel like a complete story. It doesn't feel like just a story. I think without a doubt, that is the crux of my entire argument. There are parts within the story, especially the final scene, the final big climax, which feels so disconnected to what happens before it, that it feels like this isn't a novel. It doesn't feel like this isn't a story altogether. You can see that there is a central story in there somewhere. The first half of the story is the central story, but as it moves on, it feels like it is catching the loose ends and kind of tying them together and creating small little plot lines that kind of create a bigger story on its own, when in fact, the first part of the story, it felt like its own story. The final climax was just awful. I think it was just absurdly idiotic. I think it was completely unnecessary, because what exactly is the point of this giant climax? Now, I understand it is technically speaking the logical climax of the entire story, and yet it doesn't hit properly. It doesn't feel like the logical climax, because the villain that he's fighting is so tangentially related to the rest of the story that it doesn't feel like he's actually completing the story, although technically he is, but it doesn't feel like he is. It doesn't feel like this is where the story should end. It feels like, oh, it should end when he defeats this villain, or when he defeats this villain, or when he defeats this villain. You know, there are smaller villains throughout, which feel more like a proper ending to the story, but he goes off to fight this one biggie baddie guy. A guy who barely affected his life. A guy that really, I understand technically, you know, it was technically he did affect his life in a reasonably big way, but it doesn't feel that way to the audience. And I think that's the biggest thing that I need to hammer home. The final climax, the little stories that are brought to the surface constantly feel like they're so lame. And yet despite these final stories, the first story, the second story, and the third story, ending more or less right before they begin on the final story, which is the one that is garbage, are all just so riveting. They're so interesting. And they're tied together in such a fascinating way, in a Stephen Kingian way, for lack of a better term. This is Stephen King. This is this loose, strung together sequence of stories that don't have much to do with each other, but despite that, fit together perfectly, except for this last story. In fact, if you cut off the last story, it still feels like a story that is including too much, because, like I said, the main story is completed at about the halfway point, and then it's picked up a little bit later, but in between, there's this whole side plot, and once I got into it, I got into it, what can I say? But it didn't fit with the rest of the story. It didn't fit at all. And for a long while, I was reading this thinking, where's this going? I don't understand where this is going. This is pure coincidence, and it worked out. I liked it. But at the time, it was pure coincidence. And I'm still not sure how I feel about that, but I have a hard time not feeling like it is a negative, because it's so barely related to the rest of the plot. Now, this book definitely handles probably the most touchy subject matter I've ever read in a book. It is so based in the reality of the difficulties of reality that it made me, it struck close to the heart, far closer to the heart than you would expect. However, there's a flip side to this in that it struck so close to the heart that I felt like it was overused. I felt like this great big tragedy, this very difficult aspect, this dark side of reality that was already barely tangentially related to the main story, was hammered home constantly and constantly. It was brought up at every time he could. Just the reminder of what happened, the reminder of the darkness was brought back constantly, and to the point where I have a hard time feeling like this wasn't overused. Like it wasn't just hit home so often that it just completely lost its punch. And maybe that's intentional, but to me it felt like that took away the gravitas of that part of the story. Because as much as I can understand the darkness of it, if it's brought back basically every page, there's only so much emotion associated with it that I can keep in my head. And as you can see, there are kind of two sides to every coin in here. These stories are so loosely kept together that it feels so Stephen King-y, and yet the parts that don't fit together are so awful, are so boring, they're so barely related that those have thrown me off, despite a very similar thing keeping me on. The overuse of the darkness in this story has just made me disgusted with Stephen King, and yet it also made me really put my heart into the book. And this is, I guess, the curse of Billy Summers. It's such a great book with so many pitfalls in it, because at the end of the day, my whole mind is fixated on what happens at the end of the book, because there are other bits that maybe other people focus on, but not me. For me, it's the end, the boring end. But following that is sort of an epilogue, if you will, that is by far the most pungent, powerful story within the entire thing. It is by far the most difficult to understand and difficult to accept part of the story. And this is probably the one thing that pushed it over to a 4 stars. This little epilogue has absolutely destroyed me. And it is the reason why I almost didn't make this review, because it made me feel something I have never felt before. And I guess that is the magic of Stephen King. And it's difficult for me to put these things together. If not for the awful final climax, I would have probably given it a 1 or 2 stars. But if not for the great big climax, I wouldn't have gotten the little epilogue that changed everything for me. And I guess that's the problem, isn't it? Other than that being the heart of the story, this relationship between Billy and another character, which is without a doubt the heart and soul, it makes the whole story. It's difficult to overstate this. It is the heart of the entire story, and yet, you know, everything, leaving that, all the extremities, if you will, are very boring. Even though that feels like the heart of the story to me, I feel like what Stephen King intended to be the heart of the story, which was a little story Billy was writing on the way, was not even close to that. Parts of the story, the beginning of the story within story, you know, like Misery style, but Misery story within story is garbage. This one's actually very, very good. The beginning of that feels very, very perfect. It feels so nostalgic. It feels nostalgic in a way that only King can catch, in a way that it has made me feel. And so that also destroyed me in a lot of ways. But to move on from that, to go on to the next bit, the next part of the story within the story, was so difficult to comprehend. It was so out of place, and I understand it's not technically out of place. It's nothing's technically out of place in this book. Nothing is, but it felt out of place. It felt technical. It felt more mechanical than the life within the story. And I found myself droning on reading it. You know, it wasn't awful. It was technically an enjoyable read, just like the climax was technically an enjoyable read, but it didn't fit. It didn't feel like it fit other than within the themes. It was just not an enjoyable read. However, I guess this coin has 3 sides, because while the beginning of the story within the story was very good, the middle was awful, and the third part, the last part, was amazing. This is probably the most creative thing Stephen King has done in a long, long time. In terms of storytelling. He does weird storytelling formats here and there, but this is really, really interesting. And it made me really scratch my head. I really thought about it even before it was revealed. I thought it was an error, but no, it really worked out to be a very beautiful, creative dump of something that you would not at all expect. I feel like you can tell that I'm a little bit out of practice for this review. I've been a little bit all over the place, but I hope that you can understand where my thoughts on this lie. There are incredible, incredible parts to this story. Parts of this story that make it easily my favorite Stephen King book of all time. Not my number one, but it's up there for sure. And at the same time, there are parts of this story that if I read and I stopped reading right after reading those parts, I would have probably thought, this is garbage. This goes at the bottom tier. And so it makes it very difficult for me to come to a complete agreement. There are beautifully tragic parts of the story, but then those tragic parts are overused. There's a beautiful way of ending the book and of all these mini climaxes that are just fantastic. And then there's the main climax, which is really awful. It kind of works out to be a deeply flawed book. A book that is great in spite of its flaws, not because of it. I haven't read a book that is so, at the same time, great and at the same time garbage. Ever. I don't think I've ever read a book like this. And yet here it is. So I guess you know my review, which is 4 stars. There are, I guess, a couple other nitpicky things that I would want to mention, which is, bro, you gotta keep politics out of this, man. Come on. What are you doing, King? Like, at first, I was like, okay, he's being fair. He's kind of writing within the characters, which is all fine and good. But Billy Summers is so obviously an apolitical man that when you write like this, when you add a joke like this, it just feels so much like the author coming in and saying, by the way, remember, I hate X person. You know who X person is. Don't lie, you know who he is. It seems so unnecessarily partisan. And I've even written down the page so that you can verify this yourself, because like, I'm not crazy, right? Like he has very fair political parts. Like, you can't remove politics from books, but you can, you know, be reasonable with it. You can insert it where it's useful, and you don't have to like put it in at every chance you have to take a jab. It's 204, which is one or two pages before chapter 12. And if you're there, you should be able to figure it out. So, you know, look at this, see if I'm right. It feels like this is such a completely unnecessary call-in. It feels like something that Billy would never even think about, because this is never brought up before.
ネルビスは正しい。スティーブン・キングは私のために話しません。私は自分でそのようなしわがれを言うことはありません。
I guess this is another two sides to every coin, because in this case, the politics was awful. But in every other case within the story, politics was great. It was very, very useful. It was very tasteful. And I enjoyed it. But except for here. And so I guess it's finally time, after a long, long while, a really long while, for me to finally put this book away in its rightful home. If you enjoyed this review, you know what to do. If you enjoy my personality and my reviews, you also know what to do. And if you didn't, you also know what to do. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to leave any thoughts or opinions about this book, I would love to discuss it in the comments down below. I will see you in the next review. Goodbye. And for those of you who are interested in a little bit of news, I'm going to leave this mostly uncut, but yeah, it's been a couple months. And it hasn't been, like, you guys know me, right? I don't sit around here not reading books ever. I'm reading Rhythm of War right now. And every time, this takes me, like, half a year. Like, just half a year. Like, I haven't been reading a bunch of, I've been reading smaller books, fair enough. I've read Diary of a Wimpy Kid, a bunch of, like, so many comics. But, you know, I haven't read any big novels in between this time. And so, I've had no reviews to put out, unfortunately. But I've been reading every day. Like, I've been working on it. I'm hoping to get Stormlight Review out by the end of August. Like, I'm really, really hoping that, because I'm not going to uni with this book, with this tome. I'm not doing that. I'm going to review the book, finish it, and get it done. But I promise you, I'm still reading. I promise you, and you guys know this, because this happened last year as well. I was reading Oathbringer, and I finished, and during that time, I took so long to write to make a review. And finally, I finished it, and I went back to normal. I was great. I hope you guys trust that I will do the exact same thing this time. I'm really hoping to get right back into things, and I have no doubt that I will. So, that's just my explanation. So, yeah. I also cannot believe that I still got subs and people were still watching me during the time. Pretty crazy.